या जाह्नवी।
Warm greetings to everyone. On behalf of Core Achievers, I welcome you all for today's webinar on career opportunities in Income Tax Department. CoreAchievers.com is India's leading online education website. We are currently operating in 10 countries across the globe and 16 states in India itself. We offer several academic and non-academic courses for personal development and professional growth. Today, the Central Board of Direct Taxes celebrated their 161st anniversary of Income Tax Day, and there would have been no better day to conduct this webinar. This webinar has been conducted in association with Jnan Prasarak Shikshan Sanstha's Rajiv Gandhi College of Arts and Commerce, Mumbai. Jnan Prasarak Shikshan Sanstha was founded on 2nd of October in the year 1979. Since then, they have immensely grown in size and academic status due to their excellence in management and educational service. Today, the Education Society can proudly claim credit for 4 degree colleges, 1 engineering college, 1 law college, 1 polytechnic, 8 junior colleges, 15 secondary schools, 14 primary schools, 14 pre-primary schools, 9 computer education centers, 2 study centers of National Institute of Open Schooling.
So we will keep this meeting in bilingual, Hindi as well as English, because some people are there who is comfortable in Hindi also. And during the meeting, if you guys have any issues, कोई भी query हो आप text कर सकते हैं, so that we'll try our best to include that those queries, उसको हम discuss करेंगे इस meeting में, हाँ. So we start from Income Tax Department only. First of all, मैं देख पा रहा हूँ कि काफी लोग हैं जो अलग अलग कैरियर हैं, जिनका बहुत अलग अलग स्टडीज का फील्ड है. सो क्या मैं जान सकता हूँ कि आप में से कितने लोग जानते हैं कि इनकम टैक्स होता क्या है? कैन वी अनम्यूट देम?
Yes, sir. Just give me 2 minutes.
Okay. So every participant must have option now to unmute themselves.
Yes. Yes. Just give me 2 minutes.
Okay.
I'll
so,
do that.
Not all. Not all. But maybe 3-4 candidates may you know unmute and may try to indulge in this meeting. They answer so that एक दूसरे का view थोड़ा पता चलेगा कि हाँ क्या है. So that it won't be a boring and थोड़ा इंटरेस्टिंग हो जाएगा, सब एक दूसरे को ज्वाइन करेंगे. तो दो चार लोग कुछ बताइए कि क्या जानते हैं आप इनकम टैक्स के बारे में, वन बाय वन. यस आशीष
सर, इनकम टैक्स इज अ डायरेक्ट टैक्स अप्लाइड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर पर्टिकुलर मतलब एक पर्टिकुलर लिमिट है सर, अगर उससे ज्यादा आपका इनकम हो रहा है तो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया जो है इंडिया के डेवलपमेंट के लिए है, कुछ उसके बहुत सारे रेट्स हैं, बहुत सारे लिमिट्स के हिसाब से जो हर एक साल वो उसको रिवाइज किया जाता है.
ओके ओके, एनीवन एल्स? प्रियंका एनिमल वेल्स, सोना सर कोई बताएंगे इनकम टैक्स क्या होता है? एनीवन?
या कैन आई?
या या प्लीज.
यस सो इनकम टैक्स इज नथिंग बट इज अ टाइप ऑफ टैक्स दैट गवर्नमेंट इम्पोज ऑन इनकम जनरेटेड बाय बिजनेसेस एंड इंडिविजुअल्स विद इन देयर ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. इट मे बी a business. It may be a salaried person. And income tax is also used to fund public services, pay government obligations, and provide goods for citizens. So basically, government takes taxes from the salaried and other people, those who are rich in the society, and invest it on the development of the country and the states.
Very good, very good, very good so far. Anyone else? Okay. No issues. हम बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट पहले पकड़ते हैं, है ना? जैसे नाम से ही पता चलता है, इनकम टैक्स. इनकम टैक्स इज अ टैक्स ऑन इनकम. ओके, सो द थिंग इज व्हाट द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस ने बेसिकली हम दो भाग में डिवाइड कर सकते हैं, ठीक है, विच इज सीबीडीटी एंड सीबीएसई. डायरेक्ट टैक्स एंड इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स को अपनी भाषा में हम बोलते हैं. So presently we are discussing about CBDT, which is direct tax, which is only income tax is there. CBEC के बहुत सारे part थे जिसको भी merge करके GST बना दिया गया है. Fine, if required we'll do a Zoom meeting on that separately also. Okay, so today we are only discussing about income tax, which is direct tax. So what government used to say कि देश को चलाने के लिए जो revenue चाहिए हमको, उसके लिए हमको एक फुल प्रूफ प्लान बनाना था. तो इनकम टैक्स एक्ट बनाया गया 1961 में. बट अगर हम हिस्ट्री की बात करें, इनकम टैक्स के हिस्ट्री की बात करें, तो टुडे वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग 161st एनिवर्सरी ऑफ इनकम टैक्स डे. इट मींस इट इज बीइंग लेविड सिंस दैट पीरियड. मतलब 161 साल हो गए हैं इनकम टैक्स से जुड़े हुए हमारे देश को, जबकि हमें आजाद हुए, वी गॉट फ्रीडम इन 1947 ओनली. ओके, एंड इनकम टैक्स एक्ट व्हिच हैज बीन इनएक्टेड ऑन 1961 ओनली. सो द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट वाज इनिशिएटेड इन द एट द टाइम ऑफ वर्ल्ड वॉर टू. द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट यूज्ड टू लेवी अ टैक्स on the basis of the people having their income. So actual funda comes from there. Whatever is your income, a proportionate ratio you need to pay to the government for the sake of development. In a very simple language, income tax ek aisa tax hai jo kisi ko bhi apne income pe dena padta hai. इसके लिए टाइम टू टाइम मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस बिल्स पास करती है, तरह तरह के अमेंडमेंट लाती है. हर साल टैक्स लेवल में कुछ ना कुछ चेंजेस करने की कोशिश भी होती है, ताकि किसी पे ना एक्स्ट्रा बर्डन आए और सरकार को उसका रेवेन्यू भी मिल जाए. ठीक है, सो बेसिकली वी विल स्टिक विद दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, लाइक इनकम टैक्स इज द टैक्स ऑन इनकम ऑफ वेदर एंटिटी कुछ भी हो, इंडिविजुअल हो, फॉर्म, वेदर कंपनी, वेदर एचयूएफ, व्हाटएवर इज देयर, एवरीवन इज अंडर द लायबिलिटी ऑफ इनकम टैक्स. ओके, सो नाउ बहुत बड़ा ये वास्ट सिलेबस है, सो हम इधर उधर नहीं जाएंगे. आई विल स्टिक ऑन द टॉपिक कि इनकम टैक्स में क्या अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैं कैरियर के लिए. So we will start from Income Tax Department. Firstly, I'll just give a short brief. मैं आपको Income Tax का जो structure है उस पर एक छोटा brief दे देता हूँ. See, Income Tax में बहुत सारे post हैं जिसपे direct recruitment होता है, बहुत सारे ऐसे post हैं जिसपे direct recruitment नहीं होता है. आप उन post पे via promotion ही पहुँच सकते हैं. ठीक है, तो जिन post में recruitment allowable है, which is I'm taking from the top. The first one is from UPSC IRS, and the people clearly in UPSC and becomes an IRS, joins the income tax department as
Celeste, could you please unmute yourself?
ओके, या सॉरी,
या
सॉरी, आई एम ऑडिबल? कुछ मिस तो नहीं हुआ?
यस यस, कुड यू प्लीज रिपीट योर प्रीवियस सेंटेंस?
श्योर श्योर, who clears IRS, who clears UPSC and becomes an IRS, joins Income Tax Department as a post of Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax. Okay, and that is the top post which you can be recruited directly. Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax के ऊपर कोई भी post पे direct recruitment नहीं हो सकती है. आप maximum Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax बनके ही join कर सकते हैं. उससे ऊपर की post पे आप recruit नहीं हो सकते. उसके बाद आपको promotion से ही जाना पड़ेगा. Like the structure is like that. After Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax, approximately it takes 3 to 4 years of a promotion in the most of the post. 3 से 4 साल में लगभग सब में सब कुछ ठीक रहा तो प्रमोशन आ जाता है. सो आफ्टर असिस्टेंट कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स यू हैव बीन प्रमोटेड एज डिप्टी कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, देन फर्दर जॉइंट कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, देन एडिशनल कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, देन कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, प्रिंसिपल कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, चीफ कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स, एंड इट गोज ऑन लाइक, एंड देन यू कैन रीच टू द चेयरमैन ऑफ सीबीडीटी बोर्ड. ओके, सो roughly I'll say it takes a period of 3 to 4 years for every promotion if everything is okay. So these are all the commissioned posts. Okay, for IRS people who join as a assistant commissioner of income tax, this is the job and future perspective that they may reach to the level of CBDT chairman. Now coming downwards, assistant commissioner of income tax ke niche ki jo post hoti hai उसको बोलते हैं इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर. दिस इज द गजेटेड पोस्ट. ओके, दिस इज ऑल्सो नॉट अ पोस्ट विच यू कैन ज्वाइन डायरेक्टली. फॉर इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर इट इज मैंडेटरी दैट यू जस्ट गेट प्रमोटेड फ्रॉम द पोस्ट ऑफ इनकम टैक्स इंस्पेक्टर. इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर आप डायरेक्ट रिक्रूट नहीं हो सकते. इसी तरह उसके नीचे अगर आते हैं तो वेरियस पोस्ट आर देयर, लाइक इनकम टैक्स इंस्पेक्टर इज देयर, देन बिलो देन दैट इज सीनियर टैक्स असिस्टेंट, फिर उसके नीचे आता है टैक्स असिस्टेंट, फिर उसके नीचे आता है एमटीएस व्हिच इज मल्टीटास्किंग स्टाफ. ओके, सो बेसिकली आफ्टर यूपीएससी देयर इज वन यूनिट व्हिच यूज्ड टू रिक्रूट पीपल व्हिच इज Staff Selection Commission. You must have heard about the SSC, Staff Selection Commission. Okay, so Staff Selection Commission is recruiting people for the various central government department, and Income Tax Department is one of them. Okay, so we start from the lowest again. MTS, multitasking staff. Okay, so Staff Selection Commission used to recruitment. You should do the recruitment for the post of multitasking staff. This is basically 10 class 10 plus 2 level. Okay, afterwards there is a recruitment called CHSL, combined higher secondary level examination. That is again 10 plus 2. Furthermore, there is a recruitment for stenographers also. There is a post called stenographer, which is a lateral post. Okay, so I will tell you shortly एक बार कि क्या construction है और कैसे आप कहाँ से किस में switch कर सकते हैं, because the department is basically divided into two parts, like administrative posts and taxation post. Okay, so which all post I just named, they are all taxation posts. Now if you are going to the administrative post, there are some posts like if you join as a stenographer. Okay, so you are having two options. You can go after a period of some 4 or 5 years, you may get promoted as a personal secretary. Okay, and you can go to that line also. You have an opportunity that is actually related to the taxes. You don't have do anything with the tax calculation. That is an administrative post. Further, after stenographer, you may clear a departmental exam also and can directly switch to this streamline, and you can be promoted as a post of inspector also. Okay, and after inspector, the line na, like MTS, then TA, that tax assistant, then senior tax assistant, then inspector, then income tax officer, then assistant commissioner of income tax. Okay. So this is the streamline, main streamline. But apart from this, like as I explained about the stenographer, also there is a post called senior tax assistant. So see, further, if you are unable to clear the examination of departmental examination of inspectors, you will be promoted to the post of office superintendent. After a period of some 3-4 years, you may automatically get promoted to the post of office superintendent. And from there, you can change your line to the main streamline to the different, which is administrative one. After office superintendent, you may get promoted to the administrative officer also, which is a gazetted post. Okay. So it is not like that, that there is the very versatility in the department and the structure of it. See, from MTS to TA, TA to senior TA, and again a senior TA to inspector, it will also take 3 to 4 years to get promoted. Okay. With condition to, you need to pass the required mandatory departmental examination for the promotion. But there are only two posts which used to take some more time for getting promoted. Like income tax inspector to income tax officer, it usually takes at least 8 years to get promoted after passing the departmental examination. There is a stagnation. And again, from income tax officer to the assistant commissioner of income tax, it will take some 13 to 14 years to get promoted. However, there is no departmental examination for getting promoted to the post of assistant commissioner. You can directly get promoted from the income tax officer to assistant commissioner of income tax on basis of your seniority. And this usually take 13 to 14 years in Mumbai. I'd like to mention one more thing, like being the economic capital of the country, Mumbai, is you can say the best place to work for this department especially, because this is also related to the economy. And if economy is boost, then your department is going to definitely boost. So for working the income tax department, Mumbai is the best place. Okay. So now we will just discuss about what to do for, you know, going for the departmental examination and what to do for going to the this recruitment examination. See, we are basically concentrating on the preparation of staff selection commission here. Some may be here who are looking for the UPSC also. So there is nothing to question about the UPSC. That is the best. Okay. So if we are going through the UPSC, then lines are very clear. Scope is great. You will join as a commissioned officer and a lot of things you are having in your hand. You can make things better for the department as well as the country, as well as yourself also. It's very reputed job. And I'll just tell you a short description of the department's different wings and their workings and their job nature. Okay. So I hope I'm not getting boring. Do anyone have any question? You can text me also. We will definitely cover the same in the topic. Okay. So we will just again switch to the job profile and the different wings of the department. Okay. So income tax department is basically divided in some 5 to 6 wings, you can say internally. This is not official actually. I'm just saying on the basis of different job profiles. Like the first thing is investigation. If you'll see about the income tax, the most attractive thing from outside, it is seen as investigation. Like you must have heard in the movies or any news, like income tax ki raid hui hai and all that. Okay. So there is a wing called investigation wing who used to look after the investigation things. It is their job profile to just look after the issues which has been escaped, and they are the only responsible person for all the search and seizure. It is in our local language we used to call raid, income tax raid we used to say. The basically in income tax terms it is called search and seizure. Okay, so investigation wing is definitely responsible for all the search and seizure which is happening in this country. Okay, we are having some questions like, how can you prepare SSC CGL maths by self study? What is the question asked? And definitely we will go for it, Ashish and Deepak. Definitely we will come on that topic step by step. We are coming on that. So after investigation wing, they used to just do. They are not supposed to do any assessment and anything else. They are simply doing the investigation only. So search and seizure thing is their department. One more wing is there, which is dealing with the international taxation. You must have heard about the double taxation treaty. How many of you are aware of that? Double taxation, do you know? Anyone who can say two lines about double taxation? No, no issues. I'll just make it clear. See, what happens? There is a chance, na? Like if someone is staying a part of year in this country and also staying some other places also, or is wandering to various countries, his source of income are different in other countries, and he is having yearly income from different countries with different source of incomes. Is it possible, na? So in that case, how will you tax them? If someone has earned 5 crore for in India, 7 crores in China, 4 crores in US and Japan, and many other countries are there. So how will you tax them? Where will he be taxed? He is supposed to tax in India or in Japan or US or where? So there is a big theory behind this, and that will spoil the whole day if we'll go inside. But I'll just tell you, we have a separate wing of income tax department which used to look after the international taxation and double taxation treaty. You are not supposed to be taxed twice for a single income. That's why if you have paid a tax to any country with which we are in a collaboration, you are not supposed to pay the tax again on that income. So that wing used to look after this, all this double taxation and avoidance treaty, DTAA. Okay. So further, there is a wing called TDS wing. I hope you guys were aware with that TDS. Anyone? कोई बता सकता है TDS क्या होता है? Anyone? Someone raised hand now. Who's there? I'm unable to see. 317 room number. Am I audible to all now?
Yes, sir. Actually, I have muted to each and everyone because there was lots of disturbance in the meeting.
Okay, yes.
So that's
yes,
why okay. I have just muted to everyone. So they will reply you in the chat section.
Okay. So.
And at the end, I'll unmute to all of them and they can ask you the questions directly.
Okay, so they cannot, a single candidate cannot unmute themselves, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, fine, no issues. You guys can reply in the text message. I'll just go through it. Yes, tax deducted source, correct. What is tax deducted source? Actually, this is the full form of TDS you told, na? Tax deducted source. What do you mean by that? What is the source of income? What is the tax deducted? And why it is needed, most importantly? Rajesh, will you tell? Okay, fine, no issues. It will make a noise, so leave it. Deepak Rana has raised her hand. You want to speak something? Deepak Rana, can you please unmute Deepak Rana?
Yes, sir. वो जब हम किसी को पैसा भेजते हैं ना सर, तो उसमें जो पैसा कटता है वो I think
right
मतलब tax लेता है वो deduct कर लेता
है. Yes, sir. Yes, you have stated definitely correct. You send it via message. The tax deducted source is what happens if you are having any income. Regular income or whatever in temporary income also. Government used to say that if you used to file a return at the time of end of the year, na, the July month or August month only, once in a year. So if your guys are paying the tax once in a year, then the flow of fund will be difficult to be managed. Pratik Savan said you have a doubt. You can please text your doubt. You can please text your doubt. We'll discuss. Huh? So tax deducted at source is what the government used to say that we need a continuous flow of fund to run the country smoothly. Okay. Not only from salary, Anjali, you said TDS deducted from salary. It's not only from salary. It's from any other source of income. The tax need to be deducted. I'm just coming on that. There are different, ratio. Like if you are a contractual basis, there is a 1% of the mandatory deduction, whether you are coming to that slab or not, whether your income is crossing the taxable limit or not. If you are going through any contractual basis, the payment needs to be deducted. Tax need to be deducted from the payment. After the deduction of TDS only, you can make the payment. This is mandatory for them. Okay. So similarly, as a salary, which you told, like if someone is earning more than 5 lakhs or 6 lakhs per year, so your employer knows that. And he used to deduct the TDS before paying with the salary. Okay. And this makes that TDS to be paid within a month after deduction to the central government treasury, so that the government is continuously receiving the funds to run the country smoothly. Right? You're clear? Pratik Savan, sir, example, any person have so much income and he is not paying tax to central government, so what action? Right, Pratik, we will discuss this. Okay, we'll finish the TDS issue and then we'll discuss on that. Huh? So a TDS is mandatory to be deducted if someone is having income more than the taxable limit, like salary, I have already explained. Also, if we're having some FDs in bank or any other investment, so whenever they are paying you the interest on that, okay, so the bank needs to be deduct the TDS on that. Okay, Ashish, you're saying TDS once more, na? Sure, definitely, we'll repeat it. See, what is TDS? TDS, as you said, it is tax deducted on source. Whenever anyone is being paid for anything, like it be a contractual fee or it be a professional fee for a lawyer, a doctor, CA, whatever, or a salaried person, bank interest, okay, any winning amount from lottery, okay. So this all payments, before this all payments, a TDS of a specified rate needs to be deducted. See, the TDS has been, rates has been specified for different things. Like I told, na, for contractual basis, there is only 1%. Okay. So 1% is mandated to be deducted. Similarly, at a 10% approximately for the professional fees also. So it keeps on changing. Okay. So the concept should be there, like TDS need to be deducted from the source. Okay. And the purpose I already told, that the government needs a continuous fund for running the country smoothly. That's why the TDS concept is there. Otherwise, you need to pay once in a year for the yearly income. If I'm earning 10 lakh rupees, whatever the tax has been determined, I'll pay it once. But no, the government has said we need a continuous fund. For this, there are so many interest also. If you are paying short TDS, you may be levied as 234A, B, C interest is also there. We will discuss this section some other day. Okay. One more thing is there. I'll just like to mention here with TDS, there is an advance tax. See what happens if in case you are unable to get your TDS deducted. Okay. So you can pay advance tax in that form to avoid the levy of that interest. Okay. So the government has also made a funda for companies who are not supposed to get the TDS deducted. जिनका TDS नहीं कट सकता है, companies हैं जो, ठीक है, जैसे company है, मैं कुछ manufacturing unit है मेरे पास, तो मुझे पता है कि मेरा per quarter में क्या profit होने वाला है. So उसका approximate ratio government ने decide किया advance tax payment करने के लिए, like 30%, 60%, 90% and 100% for 4 quarters, starting from June, September, December and March. Okay. So in every quarter, this much of the tax need to be paid in the form of advance tax. Like if a company is having a profit of 500 crores per year. Okay. Assume there is a tax of something 150 crores at the rate of 30%. So if the company will say, no, sir, I will pay 150 crores at the end of the year. No, this is not done. You need to pay at least 30% of that 150 crores. That is approximately 45 crores till June. That means within the first 3 months of the financial year. Again, 30% till September. Again, 30% till December, and you need to pay 100% of your tax payable before March. Okay. One more question is, any income tax officer doing illegal income, so any action? Pratik. Okay, Pratik, we'll discuss your earlier question. You asked if someone is having crores of income and is not paying a tax. Okay. See, that's what I explained about the investigation wing. This is the job profile of our investigation wing, as well as there is a system called CASS, C-A-S-S, Computer Assess Scrutiny Selection. Okay. So if someone is having source of income and is not paying proportionate tax to the department will find out the informations and will take action accordingly. And definitely they can't be skipped. In the case of, if someone is skipping, there is a option of search and survey, like search and seizure, which you call raid. Also, if they are filing the proper return, they can get scrutinized if they are escaping the income. Okay, so there are so many options there to catch up. This is our job profile. You are asking about Vijay Mallya, Nirav Modi. Priyanka is saying, sir, how to prepare yourself for the examination order? Definitely, Priyanka, this is the only true. Actually, we have a little bit diverted from this issue. We are coming back on that. Okay. So these are the different parts of the department, okay, which they are working on. Now I'm coming directly to the job profile, and then again, we will switch to the competitive examination preparation. Okay. I hope this is not getting lengthy. See, the job profile, if you'll talk from the post of Joint Commissioner of Income Tax and above, Joint Commissioner of Additional Commissioner of Income Tax and Principal Commissioner of Income Tax, whatever they're all the supervising of authority. Okay. From Joint Commissioner, supervision starts. They're completely doing supervision. Basically, you can, in our own words, you can say No work is assigned to them. They are supposed to do the supervision only. Okay? Below that, if you are coming to the Deputy Commissioner of Income Tax, Assistant Commissioner of Income Tax, and Income Tax Officer. So, as per the department's point of view, I will say this: all the three posts bears the same responsibility as they are collectively called as assessing officer. All three are doing the same job, being an income tax officer, assistant commissioner of income tax, and deputy commissioner of income tax. They are all doing the same job, nothing different. Okay? They are collectively called assessing officer. These are the section, these three posts. These are the section are supposed to do each and everything which is happening in the department. They are the signing authority to do anything. Okay? Am I clear? They are doing anything in the department which is happening. Now, coming below to the income tax officer, there is a post called income tax inspector. As the name suggests, inspector, he is supposed to do the inspections. Okay? Like if any verification is there, you need to go and verify for doing a recce for search and seizure. Anything, if someone is absconding, if someone is not traceable, it is your duty to go and find them. Okay? Also, the inspector used to assist the assessing officers in all their work. So this is the job of income tax inspector. He need to go for outdoor duties also. Okay? For that purpose, government used to compensate them as a amount of something 30 liters of petrol every month for compensation for the need of working outdoor. Okay? Now coming below to that, senior tax assistant. See, senior tax assistant is the, you can say, a technical person of the department. Like all the things which is being calculated, tax calculation, entering the same in the system, okay, making the order to be impacted on the system. These are the job of income tax inspector, right? Sorry, income tax assistant comes, senior tax assistant. Okay, this is the job of a senior assistant. Further, below that coming tax assistant. Tax assistant is basically, you know, assistant who used to do many various work in the office, like receiving the letters from the SSC, posting, dispatch, you know, official works. Right? Official works to be done by a TA. So, for a smooth working of income tax office, there is a team. Okay, the team of one assessing officer will be there, whether it's be ITO, whether be assistant commissioner of income tax, or whether be deputy commissioner of income tax. Okay, one assessing officer will be there. Depending upon the responsibility, two or three inspectors of income tax will be there in the team. One senior tax assistant will be there. There is a severe shortage of senior tax assistant in the department. So one senior tax assistant will be there in the team. One tax assistant will be there in the team. Okay. So this is the general structure of a team of assessing officer's office. Now, similarly, at the supervisory officer, like joint commissioner of income tax or additional commissioner of income tax, they are supposed to do the same thing. They are nothing different. They are called range heads. Okay. So the assessing officer is directly reporting to the range heads, whether be assistant additional commissioner of income tax or joint commissioner of income tax, either will be there. Okay. So he is called a range head, and assessing officer is reporting to them only. So in their office also, they will have two inspectors of income tax. Okay. One senior tax assistant will be there, one tax assistant will be there. Also, they have been allowed a multitasking staff also with the range heads. Assisting officers usually not been allowed with a multitasking staff. Multitasking staff are normally posted with the range head office and upper. Like range head used to report to the principal commissioner of income tax. Okay. So these are the structure of the department. Now we are coming directly to the competitive examinations. Okay. We are not supposed to discuss the syllabus of UPSC for IRS. Okay. We will do it majorly for Staff Selection Commission combined graduate level. Okay. I hope you guys may be aware about that combined graduate level examination. That Staff Selection Commission used to conduct the examination every year for several government departments, and Income Tax Department is one of them. Okay. So if we'll talk about the structure of examinations, there is basically four tiers as on date. Okay. So tier one consists of a paper of four sections. Okay. Each section constitute of 50 marks, approximately 25 questions. So 2 marks of each question. Okay. So if we'll talk about the subjects, there are 4 subjects. I'll just share that link with you guys. See, if we'll see about the scheme of the combined graduate level examination, there are basically 4 sections, which are out of which the 3 are computer based examination and only 1 is in pen and paper mode, which is descriptive paper. Okay, so if we'll talk about the tier one, there are 4 sections. The first one is general intelligence and reasoning. The second one is general awareness. Third one is quantitative aptitude, which can be said maths. And 4th one is English comprehension. Okay, so 25 numbers of questions each. Hello.
Yes, sir, we are able to hear you.
I think this page has been closed. Am I meeting now?
Yeah, you are in a meeting, okay, and we are able to hear you.
Okay, no issues. So 4 sections, 25 questions each, and 2 marks each. Okay, so 200 marks examination, and the duration of the examination will be only 1 hour. Okay, all are objective type questions, and I will tell you there will be a negative marking also, which is very important to be noted. Okay, because what happens, definitely for you guys, I must tell you, that is a shortage of time. If your speed is not up to that mark, and if you will make a mistake, or if you are marking a wrong answer, that may cause you losing marks. So you won't believe me, but let me tell you, 0.25 marks is really important in this examination. 0.25 marks, which is the negative marking. So if you'll see the merit list, approximately 5,000 people fall in this period. Like 0.25 marks, if you're short, maybe 5,000 people may go beyond you. So every mark counts, which is very important. So first of all, I'll suggest you guys to avoid mistakes. If you don't know the correct answer, don't mark it. If you are absolutely sure, then only mark the answer. This is my one suggestion to all of you. Secondly, about the syllabus of all these papers, I can share you that link with the coordinator of this meeting. Hana, they will share, huh? Because this is a very vast syllabus. It's very difficult for me to name all the chapters for them. Okay, so we will share the link, or we'll share the PDF also, so we can share to all the candidates, right? Further, after the tier one examination, this 200 marks. Abhi, can anyone tell me the expected, cutoff mark for passing the examination? What should be the expected mark? Anyone? For unreserved candidate, 57%. Deepak Arana says 60%. Nidhi Yadav says 30%. Ashish, 150. See, Nidhi, I'm agreed with you with some extent that there is a criteria that you need to pass in all the four topics individually also. Okay, so for your 30% thing, I'm agree with that extent, but overall out of 200, if you are scoring below 150, I'm 100% sure that your selection will be doubtful. Okay, so below 150, there is a no chance for an unreserved candidate. Okay, category people, there is little relaxation. Okay, so I will not discuss about that right now, but at least you need to prepare yourself to score 150 or above out of 200 to go further in the first sem, first tier one. Okay. Abhishek says 57%. No, Abhishek, it's not 57% at all. There is, what I'm saying is for going to tier two. If you are scoring 30% in each four section, also you are be declared pass. Okay. But your rank will not be there so that you will be eligible to reach to tier two. For going to tier two, the mandatory marks will be approximately 150, which is going on changing every year. Mark my words, which is going changing every year. But approximately it will fall nearby to 150 marks. Got it? Further, after clearing the tier one, you need to go for a tier two. Okay? Tier 2 again forms with 4 papers. Which quantitative abilities? Which is maths. Okay. 100 questions, 200 marks each. Sorry, 2 marks each, total 200 marks. English will be there for paper 2, 200 questions, 200 marks. There is a paper called statistics as a third paper. Again, this is a part of maths, which is 100 question and 200 marks. And the last paper, paper 4, is general studies, which is basically constitute of finance and economics. Again, 100 question, 200 marks. Okay. So if we'll say totally 200 marks was the tier one and 800 marks was with the tier two. Okay. So if you are adding tier 1 and tier 2, there is approximately 1000 marks examination. Okay? See, in tier 2, there is nothing called passing mark. Then only your merit list, which is really mattering. Okay? So tell me one thing. What marks would be required for clearing tier 2 and getting in the list of the tier 3? Anyone tell? Anyone? 75%. See, Priyanka, you're almost up to that mark because see, there are several posts in the government department. Many posts are there. Income tax department is one of that. The recruitment is being done for auditor, double AO also. Excise and custom inspector also, examiner also, and many departments are there. CCS is also there. A lot of departments are there. I will share the PDF. You will get the brief knowledge about that. Okay. So, see, the thing is what its merit depends upon the post and the department which you are asking for. Okay. So, it is not like if a specific mark is given and you will achieve that and then get this. No, it's not like that. There is an open competition एंड इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द प्रायोरिटी ऑफ पीपल हु हैज ऑप्टेड. लाइक इफ यू हैव गिवन द फर्स्ट प्रेफरेंस टू इनकम टैक्स इंस्पेक्टर पोस्ट, मे बी समवन इज देयर हु हैज गिवन द फर्स्ट प्रेफरेंस टू द एग्जामिनर्स पोस्ट, मे बी देयर इज थर्ड पर्सन हु हैज गिवन द फर्स्ट प्रेफरेंस टू द डबल एओ ऑफ द ऑडिटर. Okay, so there are several things, and on the basis of the marks obtained by them, the merit list is prepared. See, I'll tell you one thing. This is the only examination from which you can get selected for the post of income tax inspector as well as the tax assistant for the same examination. The difference is what? Marks. If you score 700 out of 1000, I'm just giving an example, rough example. If you are scoring 700 out of 1000, maybe you are not getting the income tax inspector post. Okay, but you may get a post of tax assistant and that mark with the same examination. Okay, so the marks is completely on the basis of what post you are opting. For the same examination, if someone is getting selected as a tax assistant of income tax, someone is getting selected with the same examination to the post of income tax inspector also. Just scoring 70, 80 or 100 marks in the whole examination. Okay, so if you are scoring 100 marks more, in a other way, I'll say, just you are saving your 6 to 7 years of your future. Okay, see, I'll just give you an example. If you are getting selected as a tax assistant of the income tax department, okay, and you are passing the departmental examination within time, so in 3 years or 4 years, you will get to be promoted to the post of senior tax assistant, and again, in the next 3 to 4 years, you will become an income tax inspector, okay? So it took 8 more years of the service to reach to the post of income tax inspector. Fine. You have appeared with the which examination? Staff Selection Commission combined graduate level examination. It happened because you scored something 70, 80 marks less to that candidate who joined with you as a post of income tax inspector. See, after 8 years, when you are reaching to the post of income tax inspector, he will definitely get promoted to the post of income tax officer. So he is running ahead 7 to 8 years from you just because of that 70 to 80 marks. Are you getting my point? So this is the only thing which matters is marks. For the same examination, you can get selected for some other departments also, double AOA also there. If we'll talk about the salary structure of the income tax inspector, double AO auditor and tax assistant. See how different is there. As a TA, tax assistant, you will be remunerated approximately 35,000-37,000 per month. As an inspector of income tax, you will be remunerated approximately 60,000 per month. And as a double AO of auditor, you will be remunerated starting from 67,000 per month. So see, from the same examination, from the same qualification, the people are getting different posts, different salaries, different career opportunities, different future. Okay. One question from January: are there any exemption for CS, CMA, and CS completed student who might? January, I'll just clear you one thing. See, this is a competitive examination. Okay. This has a criteria of graduation of any stream. Okay. And I don't feel like any relaxation is there for any post in for CA and CS. Yeah. Statistics may be beneficial if you are having a post of statistics. There is a post of statistical invigilator. And for that, graduation in statistics is mandatory. So that may benefit those candidates. Otherwise, I don't feel it any more beneficial for CA or CS because they will be treated as a simple graduate person. A Bachelor of Arts with 45% marks, 50% marks will be equivalent to him in view of this staff selection commission. Clear? So, okay, so this happened to being a tier 2. Now further, if we'll move to tier 3, because the examination not finished yet. Okay, so in tier 3, there will be a descriptive examination. However, this is just for passing nature, probably, as I feel that marks of this examination will not make any difference in the merit. But you need to pass this examination mandatorily. Whether it is an optional subject, you can choose either Hindi or English. There will be essay, precise letter, application, like this all question will be there, totaling 100 marks, and which is only, you know, passing nature. After passing this, your final merit list will be prepared. Okay, and on the basis of your mark as well as your preferences opted, okay, you will be allowed the departments. Like if you are giving 15 preferences, there are various posts. Okay, so if you are giving 15 preferences, so the staff selection commission will shortlist you as per your mark to various you know, departments and posts. Okay. Sorry. So in that case, further you need to go for a tier 4 examination. Okay, so like it depends upon your post which you are getting. Like if you are getting, if you are eligible for the post of income tax inspector, there is no tier 4. Okay, no need to appear for tier 4. Tier 3 is final for you if you have been selected for income tax inspector. Whether if you have been selected for the post of tax assistant, you need to go for a tier 4, which is a DEST test. Okay, so there will be a typing test. Okay, again, if you have been selected for the post of examiner in excise and custom, you need to go for a tier 4, which will be some examination related to your Excel sheet. Okay, so it depends upon the post and the department, and the tier 4 you need to go for. Whether it is not applicable, you need not to go for a tier 4. Only tier 3 will be your final results, and on the basis of that you will get the opportunity to go and appear, and you can join the department. Okay, so this was the brief. Many things we covered in this topic, many things left to be get discussed. So I'll just ask you guys, if you guys are left with any other question, you can definitely ask me. Yeah, Rajneesh, you are asking, is there any lateral entry for lawyers to serve this country through income tax? Definitely, Rajneesh. I was thinking to discuss this. There is a lateral entry for lawyers, but you know, that is not very specific. That depends upon, as a, you know, special counsel department used to recruit, but this is not very regular. There are an optional chance, and basically many people who are retired from the department used to pursue law, and they used to go for it after retirement. Even they used to opt to go for a voluntary retirement before the age of the retirement, and they used to practice and represent the department in the court of law. Okay, so for that I'm actually not sure when it is recruited, but there is a lateral entry, and I'll definitely get back to you in personally with all the details regarding it. But there is a lateral entry for lawyers to serve the country via income tax department. There is definitely a chance, but that is not so regular as a staff selection commission, that every year there will be exam and you can appear. Okay, so next question is, Ashish, how to prepare for paper 4 of senior TA? See, Ashish, senior TA, I already told, there is a no examination that you can directly been recruited for senior TA. You can go for a post of tax assistant, a and type 4 will be DEST test, like a typing test will be there. Maybe in 15 minutes you need to type 2000 strokes of key. Okay. Damini is asking when we should prepare for the exemption, before graduation, after graduation, or while we are doing it. Definitely a very good question, and maybe this will benefit to all. See, Damini, next question is asking how long it takes. See, it depends upon you that what time you take. Basically, for the idle period to get it started for the preparation is at least the final year of the graduation. As soon as you clear the second year of your graduation, you definitely need to start preparing seriously for the examination. Even you can start earlier than that also. Because what happens in the class 10th and 12th, which maths you used to do in graduation, and there are many circumstances that you change your stream. Okay, maybe you select arts, maybe you choose commerce, maybe you choose science as a botany or zoology or maybe physics. So there will not be a so interference of mathematics. As well as if you're a science student, you will not be an interference with a social studies that time. Okay. So I will suggest it that you start preparing after passing the class 12. Not thoroughly, but at least find an hour for this, so that you can be in touch with the things which you have done earlier in class 10th and 12th. And that will be helpful, because in the examination, the question was not in the level of class 12. They are not asking the question related to calculus. They are just asking the question related to class 10 syllabus. Okay. So when after doing graduation, there is approximately 5 years passed, you have left all the things. And again, if you're starting, you need to go through from starting. Okay, so I'll suggest you after class 12th, you need to prepare for the Staff Selection Commission, so that you will not need to spoil your year for this. Nupur Kumari is asking why SSC exams are being taken on time. I'm not getting this question. Taken on time, it's a good thing, na? SSC examination are being taken on time, that's a good thing. Earlier, before 2010, it was very irregular. Maybe in 2 years, maybe in 3 years, there is the Staff Selection Commission exams got conducted. But after that, I have seen that every year there is an examination. Right now, so that is a good thing. Now, if it is having every year, that is a great opportunity for you all. See, day by day, the vacancies of all the departments are reducing. This is a different policy. We should not discuss this, but this is happening, and this you can take directly as a lack of opportunities are getting reduced. That's why the competition is getting increased, and you need to score more than 150 out of 200. Earlier, it was not like that. Earlier, it was if you are scoring 110 out of 200, it's a good mark. But now 150, you will not be selected even. So just think of the merit list, final merit list, going to 190 out of 200. So people are scoring that. If I'm getting someone scoring 119, why will I ask for 120 candidate? Getting a point. So the competition is going on increasing, in only the reason being the reason is the lack of opportunities, lack of vacancies. Many departments are not opting. They are getting demolished. They are getting, merged with other department. The restructuring is not getting there. Many new posts are not getting created. Many things are there. Even government policies are there in behind this. So we should not discuss that. But see, finding anything negative in anything will take you a step behind. Just try to find something positive in everything and get yourself one step ahead. We should not think like, okay, we are getting shorter vacancy. Just think you need only one vacancy, no? Go for it. Hit it hard. Prepare yourself. Be like that. Be eligible for that and you will be picked. Why not? Any people used to say that we are not getting proper opportunity to get selected to the department, government department. ऐसा नहीं है. Government department में वैकेंसियां कम हुई हैं, खत्म नहीं हुई हैं. You can come. It is really dynamic. And more importantly, I was eagerly waiting to this sort of lecture, especially targeting the audience from Mumbai. I'll tell you why. See, I joined this department in 2014. Okay. So many of our colleagues there in the department who are very old, earlier the people are requested to join the government department. And if you are talking about before 1980s, people are requested and being called, you please come and join the department, work with the government department. People were not willing to work in the government department. They used to say, I'm not a servant. Why should I be a government servant? I'm not a servant. Maybe it varies with the cows and mentality. But when I joined this department, I must tell you one thing, it's personal little. I'm basically from Jharkhand, and which year, which had appeared for the this Staff Selection Commission, there were nil vacancy for Bihar and Jharkhand. Okay, nil vacancy. No vacancy was there for the Bihar and Jharkhand. Everybody wished to work within their state, within their home. Okay, so I didn't find any vacancy in the Jharkhand and Bihar. And I have been allowed to join the department in Mumbai. Okay. So see, approximately 1400 kilometers far from my home, I am here in Mumbai and joined the department for the sake of my job. Okay. What happens, many people in those states, because there is definitely shortage of vacancies. Many places are there. I earlier told na, this being a economic capital of the country, the best place to work for the department, revenue department, especially for the income tax department. Okay. So we are having a lot of vacancies here in comparison to other places. You won't believe that since last 10 years in Bihar, they may hardly recruit 100 people in 10 years in comparison to approximately 10,000 people in Mumbai. Okay. But this is a big difference. Nupur asking which subject to focus much and how can we go through it, also from where to start. See Nupur, I'll definitely tell you one thing, ki there are four sections, okay? And if I'll tell you, go for maths, go for English, okay? So if you are best in maths and English, you are scoring 100 marks out of these two sections. Okay? Your wisdom is not so good. Your general knowledge is not so good. What will you do? You will score 100 in these two sections and maybe 20, 20, 40 marks in both the sections. Okay? So again, after scoring outstandingly in maths and English, you are not getting selected because you are scoring 140 marks only. Despite scoring 100% marks in maths and English, you are scoring 140, which is not been selected. So the theme is what? You need to be have good command on all the papers because every mark count. If you need to score 160 marks, the average should be 40 marks of each paper. So you cannot say that I will not have a good command in only one subject. I'll prepare three papers. Then only I am not thinking that is going to work. Okay. So, ne kehte na sarv gun sampann. You should be good, having good command in all the papers. Okay. So I was somewhere. I was talking about the candidates of Mumbai. So, please don't take anyone personally. Many of my official colleagues are there who used to say that the husband and wife both are working in the department, or maybe one people are working in the department, but their children are not eager even to join the department. They used to go for a private job. Okay. What happens? And the places like Mumbai or Delhi or Bangalore or maybe the high-tech cities, the candidates and especially the students of class 12th and graduation, they got attracted towards working. Okay. They used to feel like, okay, we are working as well as earning. It's a good thing. See, in some cases, there may be some miserability if you are unable to go for the studies only, and if you are bound to help your family. I'm not talking about them, but those who are doing this for their pocket money and their self causes. So they used to join somewhere like in call center and any other places, because without qualification you will get this sort of job only. Okay, so you are joining call center earning 10,000, 15,000 per month as well as doing your graduation. Okay, so what is it resulting in? You are not able to concentrate on studies, you are not going to the correct path, and after the missing of golden period, I'm saying golden period because this is the period which you can use for your building up your future. If you are lose this golden period, you will not get it back. So after you are reaching 25, 27 or 30, now you will be forced to work something to run your life. You need to go for a private only because you're ineligible. Your age has been passed. 27 to 30 years is the maximum age limit for maximum of the post in the Staff Central Commission or any other government department. Okay. So I will suggest you guys to not to think in that manner because I'm earning 15,000 today. No, because that 15,000 today is dragging you behind. Today you will enjoy it a lot. At this age without qualification, you're getting 15,000. Okay, great. But what? You are just spoiling your precious golden periods, which you can use to build up your career. You can study well. You can earn something in the form of knowledge we can use for yourself. So this is the only thing which I notice, especially in Mumbai, because see, in small places, they are not having any such opportunities even. So they are bound to study. They know that we don't have any other opportunity. I have to study. I have to be eligible. I need to earn the knowledge and I need to prove through the competitive examinations. Okay. But here, the places like in Mumbai, Delhi, Bangalore, and very high-tech cities, you are getting many opportunities to work as well as you study. See, again, exemptions are there if it is mandatory for you, if you want to need to support your family. Definitely go for it. I'm not, disguising them. But if you are going for a self cause, just if you want for pocket money, if you want some money, then if you are doing, I'll suggest to avoid the same. And please study with the fullest. Give your 100% shot. Because you'll get a life full of time for doing other things. But this precious time, if once passed, will not return back. No way. Okay. So this is the thing which I like to convey. I don't know how many should I need to convey, but I felt it because I had any communication with many of the people and I have personally, guided them. Many of them has been converted also. They have changed their mind. They studied well. And they have achieved something. Again, many of the people working here, they really used to say like, you guys are really hardworking. You come all the way from Bihar and Jharkhand to work in Mumbai. See, our son and daughter, our children are not even willing to work. See, if you are in Mumbai, there is a great opportunity for you. You are having your home here. You need not to switch any other place. It is your place. You can work here easily, simply. You'll get a great job opportunity. What a department. If you'll say something, I'm working with income tax department, that guy is amused. also working, if you are working anywhere, you are getting salary, okay? But here, you'll get an additional satisfaction that you are doing something directly for the country. You are gathering money. You are gathering money in the form of tax for the department to run the country, right? It's not always taking a machine gun and stand at the border to serve the country. You can serve the country from here also. You can be honest. Even being an honest taxpayer also, you are being a part to making the country. Right? So you should go for it. As a reputed department is there, reputed job, office work, and the security is the most important in the government jobs. You have joined once, there's no one who can take you out from the job if you have not done anything unlawful. Okay, if you are working honestly, the job is secured. You need not to think about the future also. The wholehearted, you can work and do something for the country as well as the department as well as the yourself. You can attract other people also to come towards you. You can spread the awareness, right? So this topic will not finish anywhere. So I'll just ask you if you guys have any other queries, or if you guys need any other, you know, session on the syllabus and all, we can arrange with the help of the coordinators. We'll talk about that, you know? And I will definitely share the PDFs with the coordinators so that you can go through it. And if required, we will have a brief discussion on that also, the topics. Nidhi, yes, you said syllabus PDF. Definitely, I'll share with the coordinators because right now I'm not having it handy. Okay, so I'll definitely share with the coordinators and they will share with you. Thank you so much, Rajneesh. Very nice word from you. See, exactly, I used to feel like that. In fact, from my birth, I always wanted to serve the nation, joining the department, joining the army. Okay, but maybe there are some circumstances and some things happened so that I couldn't join the army. But today also, I am satisfied with myself. Like, okay, fine, I'm doing something for the country. Thank you so much for your words. Definitely, it's a feeling. That's a great feeling. Whenever you go for a search, whenever you solve a case, whenever doing assessment, whenever do your verification, when you find something which has escaped, it will give you the pleasant surprise, like if you're doing something for the country. However, it is expected from everyone, you know, that you should be honestly paying the taxes. Okay, because it is your right. It is your right for the country. It is your duty to make yourself apart from the nation building. But some people are there who are using the concealment and escaping from assessment. That is what this department needed. And we are meant for that. See, no one likes us exactly who are stealing money and concealing. Never like us. Fine, we are bad for them. Because we need to be good for the country. If someone is stealing 1 crore rupees, okay? See, directly he is, stealing approximately 30% of the 30 lakhs rupees plus interest and penalty, it's approaching to 50 lakhs or 60 lakhs. See, when we find someone having a concealment of 1 crore, we need to recover approximately 60 lakhs from them, at least. And when this amount is recovered, we used to feel that we have done a contribution of 60 lakhs to the country. If we won't have been there, that amount has been to their pocket, that black money. Okay? So it's really a very good feeling. if you guys will join the department, you will definitely see how dynamically we used to work. We used to, you know, find many things, and very intelligence is there. What all I should tell, there's something confidential also. I should not tell you everything. Okay. But let me tell you only one thing. You guys will not feel bored in a single day in this department. There is everything, something new every day. And dynamic. Ashish is asking, how many months required to study and finally get the job? See, Ashish, it's nothing like a course, okay? Like with a 2 years course or 3 years course. You should have it in you. What time you take yourself to get developed to the level of the examination? Because see, if I'll compare the level of examination in the last 5 to 7 years, a severe change has been seen. Okay. In fact, if I'll talk about myself, I have cleared the Staff Selection Commission in 2012 and I joined the department 2014. Okay. So at my time, the cutoff was, I think, 98 marks out of 200. Just 98 marks out of 200. Okay, but the level has also been little different. Okay, the level was also different. So that 98 marks has today reached 150. So you can yourself assume the level of competition. So I cannot say that time, like what time you will take to reach to that level. Okay, so you should be prepared for that, and what time you can do it for within a year or maybe in 3 months. And I'll tell you one thing, maybe some of people over here may not believe me, but I have not even joined a coaching for this. I have done this on my own. I prepared at home only. I've studied by myself. No special teacher for the Staff Selection Commission, no tuition at all. What I did was by my own. In fact, prelims I have given in a fun. When I cleared the prelims, then only I came to know about the structure of the Staff Selection Commission, because I just filled the form of the Staff Selection Commission looking after my friend. My friends tell, okay, we are, this form has come. Okay, let's go and fill it. Sabne bhara, maine bhi bhar diya. मजाक मजाक में एग्जाम दे दिया. जब प्रीलिम्स क्लियर हो गया, टीयर वन क्लियर हो गया, तब मुझे पता चला कि व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द स्टाफ सिलेक्शन कमीशन एग्जामिनेशन, एंड देन ओनली आई प्रिपेयर्ड वेल. सर, व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंट रिसोर्सेज थ्रू विच यू कैन डू योर प्रिपरेशन? सी नुपुर, आई विल जस्ट टेल यू, यू नीड टू फिगर आउट योर सेल्फ विद द हेल्प ऑफ द सिलेबस. Like what topics are there and what you need to cover. See, like similarly, there is an examination called UPSC, okay? You need not to read and remember everything. You need to be smart. What type of question they are asking, you need to be prepared for that. You need not to be a Google. Can you please give me a minute? I'm just receiving a very urgent call. Please give me a minute. Please give me a minute.
Yeah, sure, sir. Sure.
Sorry, very sorry. It was a little unavoidable call. sorry. So I was saying that, see, what you need to get prepared, you need to, I was just answering, what was the question? Nupur. Yeah, you are asking about the resources. See, you need to firstly go through the syllabus. What syllabus need to be covered, okay? And for a mathematics, see, what I did, there was one book, which is very famous, R.S. Agrawal, and one is Dr. Sagir Ahmed, okay? So I have gone through these two books for mathematics. With Sagir, R.S. Agrawal is the only conceptual thing. It just clears your concept. And Sagir Ahmed used to help you with some tricks. Like, see, solving 25 questions in approximately 15 minutes for mathematics, it's not so easy if you are not using a trick. You cannot solve it with a traditional method. I know, out of 25 questions, 20 questions is known to you all. Everyone can solve it. But you have to solve it within the stipulated time. This is a good task. You cannot go through with a traditional method. If you are solving a question with a traditional method, every question will take at least 2 to 3 minutes. But you don't have that much time. So you need to go for a shortcut. Okay? Many messages I have received. I just answer them. Swandari was saying, how many marks did I score? See, Swandari, I told you, na, for the prelims, I was even unaware of the Staff Selection Commission. I didn't even know what is Staff Selection Commission. I simply scored 111 marks out of 150, just because of my mathematics and English. And believe me, my general knowledge was poorer than poor. I simply scored 12 marks in general knowledge out of 50 questions. So I always tell you not to repeat this mistake, because that time maybe it was not maybe that much competition so that I got selected. Otherwise, at today's date, I myself feel that at this preparation, I won't be able to clear the examination. That means you need to change. You need to go for it something differently. Like, all the papers need to be cleared with the good marks so that you can reach the final level. Otherwise, it is very difficult for someone if you are preparing with the 3 papers or 2 papers in a good command. It seems very difficult for me. Like, you can go with the selection, getting selected, being selected. I'm not a genius here. I'm very sorry. What happened? See, it's a matter of something. 8 years ago, I did. What happened? It was a situation was different. So I cannot say, but Joko, go for it. What is it now? Because that time, syllabus was different. Question papers were different. 50 marks, 50 questions used to come for each section. 200 questions in 2 minutes were there. 2 hours, sorry. So many things were there. So we cannot say anything. Surbhi, you are asking, I have joined late. Can I get details after this? Definitely, you can get details, Surbhi, as well as this is a recorded line, and you can get a link of the YouTube also. So you can get benefited from there. You can please ask to the coordinators. They will tell you about this. Okay. And sir, how many years taken you to crack this examination? Nupur, I'll tell you, na, this was my second attempt actually, because what happened, I told you, na, I was very keen to join army. Okay, so before 2012, there was a common examination, Staff Selection Commission, which has been selected for a sub-inspectors of CAPF, Armed Forces. Okay, and right now, after 2012, the separate examination is being conducted for the CAPF, SINCAPF and paramilitary forces. Okay, so I appeared for 2010 only for that. I was unaware of the Staff Selection Commission and these different posts. Okay, I had appeared for the CAPF only in 2010, but some medical condition were there. I was not finally selected. However, I just cleared the examination with good marks, but final selection couldn't be done due to some medical unfitnesses. So after that, in 2011, I could not appear. I was doing something else. And in 2012, again, I appeared and I got selected. Afterwards, you won't believe, I have given examination 3 more times. Okay. And all the 3 times I have been selected with the same post with the same department. And the same place also, Income Tax Inspector, Mumbai only. So I could not switch. I'm still here. So you can say 2012 was my second attempt. However, on the basis of the Staff Selection Commission, but for Income Tax Department, it was my first attempt. So we're asking when exam is there, I have joined late. Yeah, you can get the link of the YouTube winner. You can get the link with the YouTube and you can talk to the coordinators with this. Further, if you guys require any detail about the Staff Selection Committee, see, today's lecture was mainly concentrated with the job opportunities in Income Tax Department. But if you guys want a lecture on Staff Selection Commission combined graduate level examination, we can arrange it with facts and figures also, and I will have handy with the PDFs also, so that I can share you earlier and then only we can discuss, so that it can be more beneficial for you all. Definitely. Interested candidates may tell, so that, see, what we are doing is, if you guys are not getting benefited, then it is useless. Okay, so what all we are doing, it's for your benefit only. If 2, 4, 10, 15, 20 people are not getting benefited for all this, so everything will go in vain. Okay. So please think of it and make others also who are in surrounding of yourself, make others aware also about this and go for it. It's a great thing. What else I can tell? If you can ask any other questions, because we are having some left of time. We can discuss something else if you are having any questions. Anyone? See, if I'll talk about the Income Tax Department, whole day will become short. Many things I have, but I just wanted to stick to the topic which I'm having today. So, okay, fine. We'll discuss many things about Staff Selection Commission also. If you have any questions regarding Income Tax Department and its structure and opportunities of the job, you can ask today. We will have a different session on Staff Selection Commission, definitely. Yes, please. Those who have an issue, you will please raise your hand. You will be unmuted. Please. Anything. Don't get bothered. Anything you can ask. We're just here to discuss. Anyone, anything? Or else we can, one question was there. Someone has asked like what this department used to do with people, you know, concealing money, like.
So you are on mute. Yeah.
Okay. Sure, Sandhya, definitely. So you want to take one more lecture on this topic or on SSC Staff Selection Commission? Definitely we can plan a lecture on, yeah, SSC. Definitely we will plan. We'll plan and we will have the facts and you know, PDF handy, and we'll share the syllabus even. In fact, we'll share the syllabus and other things earlier before the lecture, so that you guys can go through it and you may raise the issues and question if you are having anything. Okay? Who else? So I should not tell any names like Vijay Mallya, Neeraj Modi. So no, it is little thing, confidential thing. But I'll just tell you one thing. See, income tax department or any other department or any law which is imposed in the country. Okay. See, we should never ever think, or we should not try to supersede that. See, the law has been made for all of us and for the benefit of all of us, I may say. Okay. So if government has imposed income tax department and he has prepared some act and law and you are supposed to pay a tax, then you should be honest in doing so. Yeah, Nupur, definitely, definitely we'll have a facts and figures of the syllabus of SSC, and we will definitely make it very early. Don't worry. Yeah, we'll come with the facts. So the department used to be working in a manner that everyone should be paying the taxes honestly. Because if you are doing so, in the one hand, you are just helping the country, helping the nation to build. Every people who are not, so capable or are staying in the below poverty limit, they are, very thankful to the people who are paying taxes. Because see, what happens if in a manner you can see that if you are eligible of paying taxes, it means you are in the top 3% of the country. Some people may be feeling strange that only 3% of the people of India are paying taxes. Rest 97% people are below the taxable limit. The taxable limit is 5 lakhs. It means more than 97% of the people of this country are earning less than 5 lakhs per year. Just imagine. And if you are earning 10 lakh, 15 lakh, 20 lakh, 1 crore, 2 crore, 10 crore, 50 crore, feel how blessed you are. You should be blessed to pay taxes, because your taxes are being used for that 97% of people, for the welfare of them, for the, needs to be fulfilled by the government. Because what government is doing, anything in the name of development with these taxes only, no? From where they will get money? They are getting money from the income tax only, or as well as the excise and custom, whatever, there are taxes only. Maybe direct taxes or indirect taxes, GST, stamp duty, stamp, income tax, many things are there, okay? So the government is very much needed for the taxes, because they need money for the development. It is a rotational process. If we are not paying, then we are not getting back. If you're getting a road outside your home, if you're getting train, you are getting metro, you're getting aeroplane, you're getting 5G, you're getting many things, you're getting anti-ballistic missile, you're having an Air Force aircraft, anything which you can say, anything which you can name, it's coming from this money. So you can say that indirectly you are buying an Indian aircraft jet. You can say you are buying a COVID vaccine with your tax. You're blessed, huh? You're blessed to do something for the country. See, in that case, it's a different matter, like whether you're working with the government or you are in a private field. Okay. But as a consumer, you should come forward and pay your taxes honestly. If everyone is honest, then why this department is needed? No need, na? So many people are not paying their taxes honestly. If everybody starts paying taxes honestly, the department will be finished. We are no more needed. Many countries are there where there is no income tax department, or many other countries are there where there is no income tax even, because they are having another source of income. They no need to take taxes from their civilians. But we are not having that much. Our country is a farmers' country. More than 70-75% people are farmers here. Okay, we are a progressive country. We are progressing. We have not progressed yet. So we need funds. So everybody should be honestly paying the taxes to make a hand in the building of nation. प्रधानमंत्री श्री मोदी जी बोलते हैं ना आत्मनिर्भर भारत. क्या है आत्मनिर्भर भारत? सो दैट इफ यू आर हैविंग प्रॉपर फंड्स वी कैन डू द रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट इन आवर कंट्री ओनली. वी शुड नॉट नीड टू बाय एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम अब्रॉड. व्हाई वी नीड टू इंपोर्ट एवरीथिंग? बिकॉज वी आर नॉट सेल्फ डिपेंडेंट इन एवरीथिंग. वी आर नॉट वी आर हाउ मच वी आर पेइंग इन द रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट? डू यू नो? Can anyone tell what percentage of the revenue collection of the budget has been allocated to research and development? Anyone? Anyone? Nona? You will be surprised to know only 0.6% of the GDP is being allocated to research and development. 0.6%. Less than 1% even. Why? Neither we have faith nor we have that much of fund. Because the major fund goes to the defense sector. Research and development in that sector only. See, this is a policy matters. We should not discuss in very deep, but I definitely will tell you that yes, our country needs funds and we should be honest. Because see, if any act is passed or financial bill is passed, you need to supposed to pay 30% of tax on your income. Then you should pay that now. Because many working, many homework, many people are behind that to settle that tax slab. After great research only, they used to fix it like this tax, this amount needs to be taxed on this rate. Then if it is communicated by the government that someone earning more than 10 lakh rupees need to pay 30%. So they need to pay 30% of tax. Honestly. Okay. What else I should tell you about the income tax is something like one thing I'll also tell you. One of our wings are there in settlement commission called. That person called, which is asking about Neera Modi and Vijay Mallya, and was asking what our department used to do if someone is escaping the income tax or whatever. So, see, after search and seizure of anyone, like very recently, some newspaper company has been covered under income tax search and seizure action. Okay. So see, it's a very long procedure. Severe research and verification is there behind the search and seizure. After proper information and proper verification only, we get an approval for a search of anyone. Because we always keep in mind the right of natural justice of anyone. Okay, so we are not supposed to do anything unfair with anyone. So once we are 100% sure that there is an escapement of taxes, there is you know some stealing, then only we get an approval of search and seizure, and then only we can conduct an action. Okay, so after that, many things are there. Like if someone wish to go to the settlement commission, they can opt. Settlement commission is a thing which any SSC means, we used to call them SSC in a different mode, like an individual, a company, a firm, an HEF, okay, an AOP, many things are there. Collectively, we used to call them SSC. So any SSC can opt for settlement commission once in their lifetime. They cannot go twice. Only once they can go for a settlement commission. And he, some things are there, like he has been allowed with the immunity of penalties and prosecution and all that. Okay, so if we'll go through the Income Tax Act, we can find out, because many of you will not understand about that, because it's a very deep thing. Sometimes we'll get a time, we'll discuss it. Okay, so many things are there in the different, really dynamic department, and you will definitely find everything very in a new manner. Every day something new will be there. So great challenges. And what to tell about the dimensivity? If you say anything about the department, you always come to know in the news also. And what is Income Tax Department? What they are doing? So I wish I can see many of you all as a future of the Income Tax Department, and I welcome you. Okay. So I think we should conclude this lecture, and definitely we will come back with a session on SSC examination or anything else if required. Okay.
Okay. That was a wonderful and informative session, sir. I would like to thank you for sharing your precious time and knowledge for our betterment. And I would also like to thank everybody who attended this webinar. Thank you all once again.
Yes, thank you. Thank you from my side also for having some listening me so patiently. And I hope this will be very helpful to you all. See you soon in the future also. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.